And next, bright lights over the bay. NewsHour correspondent Spencer Michels reports from San Francisco on a work of public art.
For 75 years, the Bay Bridge has been the workhorse on San Francisco Bay, linking Oakland and San Francisco and carrying 270,000 cars and trucks a day. On the San Francisco side, its towers support suspension cables that keep the bridge deck up. But this gray utilitarian structure that partially collapsed in the 1989 earthquake has never captured the world's attention the way its nearby cousin, the Golden Gate Bridge, has. Built toward the end of the Depression, both were engineering marvels. Now the Bay Bridge is making its own splash. On a cold, rainy night last week, it was transformed into a giant work of art. 25,000 tiny white undulating LED lights strung from the vertical cables were turned on in a flashy display of public art that can be seen for miles. For California politicians like Lieutenant Governor Gavin Newsom, it was a chance to tout the area's uniqueness.
Here we are in San Francisco, a wacky and wonderful place, and a city that's probably best described as 49 square miles surrounded by reality.
The high-tech installation, which is called the Bay Lights, is being billed as the world's largest LED light sculpture. It's also a major piece of public art, an increasingly popular and often increasingly controversial art form, like the gates in New York Central Park by Christo, or the New York City waterfalls by Olafur Eliasson, or Cloud Gate, a public sculpture in Chicago, by Arneesh Kapoor.
Thank you so much.
Bay Lights is the creation of Leo Villarreal, a New York City artist who specializes in using LED lights and computer programming in works on display at several major museums and in numerous installations. Villarreal operates his laptop using specially designed software to control and program the lights. Once set up, it works automatically. The overall effect is meant to be abstract, but to reflect different movements around the bridge, from waves and boats to traffic and clouds.
So when you finally pulled the switch on this the other night and the lights came on, what was your own personal reaction?
It was overwhelming. I mean, it was really very, very exciting. So I worked very hard to integrate this piece into its environment, but it's not specific, and it's meant to be open-ended, highly subjective, so you can just relax, be with the piece, and take from it what you will. And you'll never see the exact same progression of sequences twice.
The lights, which are on every night from dusk until 2 a.m., can be seen only on the side facing north, toward Alcatraz and the Golden Gate Bridge. Drivers on the Bay Bridge cannot see or be distracted by the lights, one of many safety precautions dictated by a host of government agencies.
Installing the piece is also incredibly challenging. We had workers 525 feet up over the water at night from 11 p.m. to 5 a.m. for months on end.
It's cold up there.
It's cold. You know, you have hundreds of thousands of cars rushing at you with a couple of cones protecting you, and dangling, over the water at night.
The $8 million project is being financed entirely by private donations. So far, $6 million has been raised, much of it by public relations man Ben Davis, who came up with the idea. The rest of the money is still being raised.
This is going to bring, in my estimation, hundreds of millions of dollars into the local economy. I think we're going to smash all records for public art.
Is there something a little commercial about all of that?
Not really, because that money's not going to anything but the communities that are here already. There's nobody catching a profit from this involved in the project.
Public art used to consist mostly of statues of generals or politicians. Today, many cities are requiring developers of large projects to pay 1% or more of construction costs for public art. J.D. Beltran, who teaches public art at the San Francisco Art Institute and is president of the Arts Commission, says getting public approval is tough, especially for complicated or abstract works.
Many times the public feels like, because they don't understand a piece, it's being shoved down their throat and they don't like it and they'll be very vocal about it.
But Beltran, who was not part of the project, says the Bay Lights works as public art.
It doesn't take much to understand because it's a gorgeous piece. I think it's beautiful, it's delightful. It fulfills all of those requirements, I think, that the public wants in terms of a piece of public art. I think I can safely say it's pretty universally liked.
Unless they malfunction as they did last weekend, the lights will remain lit every night for at least 2 years. A few years after that, the bridge will need painting and the lights will have to come down.
Spencer has written more about the Bay Bridge in a blog. You'll find that on our website.